Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Thank you all for coming here. It's an honor and privilege for me to open. We're just going to go right into the program. We have programs over there if you need one. Just a little bit about this part of our professional development program. This is the first time we did this eight-month session called the Chief Officer Program. And this allows this group to not only better understand the jobs they're in, but prepare them for the future and prepares our department for the future. So we're really excited about this. I'll tell you more about it a little bit later. But first, I want to introduce the Honorable Mayor Tom Watson for opening remarks.
Well, I'm pleased to be here. I have to tell a quick story just for the heck of it. A friend of mine in New York, above the knee amputee like me, and we were putting this kind of experimental leg on him with a microprocessor and a computer-driven and all this Bluetooth stuff. And he actually worked for the Port Authority on the floor, 86th floor or something. And the feature on this knee would allow you to run foot over foot. And he was able to escape from the tower alive with that new prosthetic knee. And he never said one word about the knee. All he said was, man, I was running like everything to get out of there. And those guys were running into that trouble. And that's the first time I'd ever heard of that remark about what you guys do. Because like police and fire, us normal people, you know, if you have some fire, am I going back in there to see what's going on? You guys do. So you have a special place in all of our hearts, and I'd like to recognize our other elected officials, Commissioner Pam Smith Wright, Commissioner Bob Glenn, Commissioner Jay Velotta. There's that little guy in the corner. Oh, that's Nate, and Nate Pagan. He's our assistant city manager. But we are proud of our fire department, and when city manager and I go for it, baby, I love it. When it was time to make a change, let me have him. We had a terribly tough decision to make, you know, continue as you were going, or would we go outside and try and find another leader for a very close-knit group. We met with some verbal consternation by a lot of folks, but we got two bugles and we started blowing them. I didn't know what a bugle deal on the thing. And we hired what was then an outsider, and Chief Mitchell, and I think he's done a very, very good job bringing our fire department to a very professional standing, and we're very pleased with that outcome.
So just a little bit about the program. We developed this over a year ago. It was an eight-month program. This group signed up for it to go into it. It was there's a standard that we have to go by called NFPA 1021, and it's what fire officers need to go as they move up the ladder. So what you see them do and talk about, like the ones that just left, that kind of reminds me. I went to a fire chief's retirement not too long ago, and just as the mayor and city manager were getting ready to do their remarks, the entire room emptied because they got a working structure fire, and there was the retiring chief standing there by himself with his family, and that was simply people left in the room. So that happens. So they went through this eight-month process. Where up till now, they've been learning the emergency side. Now it was time to get them the administrative side, how the city works. So just some of the things they had to do. They had to complete a budget project. They had to take a training budget request and whittle it down, what was it, about 30 grand? So they could get a little idea of what my job's like. Then they learned the city manager form of government that we have here in Owensboro. They learned from each city department what they do, who does what in those departments, and how they interact with the fire department. 3 days of human resource training. We have 99 personnel. We are human resource heavy. and there's a lot to do with that. They spent 3 class days just on human resource issues. Of course, we can't do our business if we can't buy things, so they have to know the purchasing policy and procedures and how that works. And they also needed to know, what do the chief officers do? What are the ones that do above them as they look to move into those positions? So they had to learn those. Very important, emergency management functions and mutual aid, what we do outside the city, who we mutual aid with, who we respond with. A big section was probably about a day and a half, laws, regulations, and outside influence. Fire departments are heavily regulated by numerous other agencies, federal and state. They needed to understand that and who we have to follow, and that's one of my jobs, is make sure every day that we're compliant with those regulations. We went over to legal cases. They had to take home, they had to study some legal cases and some case law in the fire service and come back and present those to the others on what they found out. And then last but not least, a very important part of our job, one of the biggest supports, community relations, and that's through media relations. And they had to learn how to do interviews, how to work with the media. And I'm going to introduce Leslie Neely as the instructor of that. She's going to give you her perspective on how that went.
Thank you, Chief. I'm honored to be here and be in your all's presence, and congratulations, and honored that Chief Mitchell asked me to speak from the perspective of an instructor. I found a quote that I thought was pretty fitting for this: courage is not living without fear. Courage is being scared to death and doing the right thing anyway. Now, while you all are faced with dangers and potential disasters every single day, I think some of you all were more anxious and scared of being in front of a camera than being in front of a structure fire. And I had the privilege of walking all of these gentlemen through the ins and outs of media, media relations, community relations, and navigating those vicious television, radio, and newspaper reporters and how they can catch in something. So we did have some fun along the way. I'm not looking into legal cases. I'm not as serious as personnel, but it's still very important to know how to navigate the world of media relations. But I thought we had some fun, and I thought I would show you some of that fun.
So there's a fire right here. Yeah. We're putting water on the fire, and the fire's gonna go out.
Jason Pickerel.
Can you spell it for me?
JasonPickerell.
Wait. Who's this other guy behind you?
Hello, Miss Lady.
Totally off the record.
All right.
Do you think you got a big enough raise?
Totally off record?
Totally off record.
Sure.
Ready?
So there's no double takes if I mess up?
Nope.
All right.
Nope, they don't let you.
So do I get to do like Chief and say, what's he ask? He asked what the 3 questions are before we get started.
You know what I'm saying? Nope.
Is this live?
We're recording it.
We're recording it today.
Okay.
But other than that,
okay.
It's not live.
Well, I have to think of a one in my head.
I don't know what I'm supposed to do with my hands. I remember we were talking about that last week. I was not supposed to do with my hands.
Ready to go?
Let's go.
Whenever you're ready.
Rowan.
Well, you won't have to try too hard because I'm not much of an on-camera personality.
I think you did a wonderful job. Good job.
Is it over?
So you'll see that we had some fun with the homework. So I did a presentation on the do's and don'ts when it comes to being interviewed and being on camera. And so with that, each of the firefighters had to do a little bit of homework. They had to come see me in the studio, and I did a mock interview on camera. This was the funny part. They all actually did really, really well. I asked them questions from, what's going on behind you, and I tried to catch them by saying, do you feel safe? Should the neighbors feel safe? I tried to catch them in, oh, no, this is totally off the record. What do you think of the budget cuts? And they did wonderful. They did phenomenal. So I know that all of these gentlemen are totally prepared to be in front of the worst reporter that comes at them. I know that they're so prepared. So again, congratulations. I'm not going to show the good stuff because it was good, but this is the better stuff, the funny stuff. So congratulations and wish you all the best.
So what we'd like to do now is just show you a little bit of a video about the fire department and who we are, and then we'll get into the certificates.
Look into my eyes, you will see what you mean to me. Search your heart, search your soul. And when you find me there, you'll search no more. Don't tell. Everything I do it for you. Look into your heart, you will find there's nothing there to hide. Take me as I am.
Their certificates say Owensboro Fire Department, in recognition of successful completion of the 8-month course of study, the certificate of completion is presented upon their name for the dedication to serve the citizens of Owensboro and the fire service through the continued professional development and the completion of the Chief Fire Officer Academy, May 2nd, 2018. Bobby Gray. James Howard. Kevin Lamb. Chris Lutz. Richard Peach. Jason Pickford. Glad you got to come back.
Nick and Morris couldn't do that without you.
No, they handled it just fine.
Tim Fryer. Is his hair look on?
Yeah.
Colter Tate.
Thank you. We're here at Owensboro High School to do their annual ghost out. We have OPD is here, the Owensboro Fire Department's here. We have a two-car wreck here that the OFD personnel now are gaining entry into the car, couldn't get in there. We have injured patients that EMS just took, loaded and packaged them all up like we properly do. And they're in the back of the ambulance now. Like I said before, the personnel now are trying to get the injured victims out of the car. To my right here, Officer Johnston is talking to OHS students about drinking and driving and what happens when you do that. And they're supposed to have a helicopter here, but I don't think they've made it yet. But this is an annual event that Officer Johnson usually puts on, and OFD is here today just to help out. Well, we can obviously get to use our jaws of life. We have a rescue truck that we usually man two people with, so they'll get to practice with the different tools that we have. You get to cut the roof off and pop the door, so anytime we can do something like that, it'll help us if we have a real life situation. Well, if they take it to heart, I'd like to think it makes them think to definitely not drink and drive, and to be cautious, be defensive drivers, not offensive drivers. They had the boy out here earlier with the beer goggles, and Officer Johnson put him through a sobriety test, and he didn't pass. And anytime you're in that situation, call your parents, call someone to come get you, so you won't have this situation for all of us.
So it's important for us to make it very real for all the students and everyone participating to realize exactly how much of a risk it is to drink and drive. And we want to make it as real as possible, so we try to run the drill just as we would on the street. We do everything the exact same and try to just make it really steady. So, anytime that we can run a simulation and when it's not, you know, actual lives in danger, and it's good practice to go through the steps that we normally would. Much like the fire department, if they were to, you know, train in a live burn house, this is kind of good training for us just to participate with students that aren't really injured and just honing our skills and just practicing. We just hope that the students realize how seriously we take it and how much we hope that we never have to do anything like this, and that they will just be safe and make smart decisions. It's an experience that kind of hits home for us. We've all had very serious runs in real life that we've had to participate in. It kind of hits home for us, because we do this so much and we really hate to. So participating in it it's a heavy load.
And anything that I didn't ask that you want to add?
We just ask that everybody stay safe, make smart decisions, have fun, but be smart about it. We would much rather I know every parent out there would rather come get their child than us to have to go get their child.